happened to be the year, which was the 50th anniversary of the Dream Speech in Washington, D.C. on the steps of Lincoln Memorial. So we thought, great opportunity. So we called it the Dream Luncheon. It's now become a banquet, as you can see, just a full crowd here tonight. We heard to our fifth annual Dream Banquet here at Champion Forest Baptist Church.
He's got the whole world in his hands. 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 He's got the wind and the rain in his hands. He's got the wind and the rain in his hands. He's got the wind and the rain in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Cesar Chavez. This is Maya Angelou and Lyndon B. Johnson, with some of our other friends. Tonight, we want to share with you what is most needed in our hearts, our community, our nation, and our world. To make a great dream come true, the first requirement is a great capacity to dream. The second is persistence. We cannot seek achievement for ourselves and forget about progress and prosperity for our community. Our ambitions must be broad enough to include the aspirations and needs of others, for their sakes and for our own.
We all should know that diversity makes for a rich tapestry, and we all must understand that all the threads of tapestry are equal in value no matter what their color.
So tonight I urge every public official, every religious leader, every business and professional man, every working man, and every housewife, I urge every American to join this effort to bring justice and hope to our people, and to bring peace to our land. You see, America, City of Houston, Champion Forest, we have a dream, the same dream as Martin Luther King Jr.
We say to you today, our friends, even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, we still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream.
We have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal.
We have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places shall be made straight, and the crooked places will be made straight. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together.
And if America is to be a great nation, this must become true. So with that being said...
What a challenge we have here to build a nation where strangers and people of different backgrounds learn to live together as one. But I'm hopeful for America because America has always done things no one has ever done before. The Wright brothers in flight, putting a man on the moon, John Glenn orbiting the earth. America's always done things no one has done before. And I believe, I know, that out of many, we can become one. Listen to these inspired words. I'm going to read you something before I leave that'll blow you away. But listen to this little poem. I came across this poem. It said, when I was small, I knew no color or creed at all. Since then, of course, I grew. Now I know Negro, Gentile, and Jew. Please, dear Lord, let me always be small, that I may never see color or creed at all.